Get ready to match the star. Savory Shriver. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Rudd. From Busting Loose, Barbara Rose. Richard Dawson. From the Bob Newhart Show, Marcia Wallace. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers!
Do you have the feeling it's like the first day that school has started?
Yes.
Is that the feeling you have? Mm-hmm. I don't know why, but we have that feeling here. It's like the first day. Number one, it's too hot in here already. So turn it down, would you please?
Why? We've been on vacation.
Yes, right.
I, for one, am very glad to be here. Testing one.
No, it's my microphone that is acting up a little bit. And I'm going to hold the cable like that
here. We've only been on 2 minutes, and already the microphones are breaking down. And no, we've been away a little bit, and we're all back, and we haven't seen each other in a long time.
We had a vacation.
You all look wonderful.
Thank you so much.
What did you do on your vacation?
Hawaii. Went to Hawaii.
You're going to write a composition for English
I will,
One?
How I spent my summer vacation.
Yes. Did you ever get to meet that wonderful guy who loves this show, who's the TV
critic? I sure did. His name's Dave Donnelly.
Yes.
And he writes a column called Dave Donnelly's Hawaii, and he thinks this is the greatest show on the air.
Well, I've got to meet him one of these days.
Say hello to him.
Yeah. It's not bad being number two.
That's it.
No, it's... Listen, we haven't seen you in a long time.
I know.
You're wearing a heart on your chest.
I beg your pardon. I'd forgotten how unusual you were.
And you, what can you say about her?
I don't know.
Well, I'll tell you
about
it. Not now. You've lost weight, haven't you?
Just a few pounds.
You want to give your non-smoking announcement? Is it 9 months?
It's 10 months, and I have laryngitis.
Now, our two players here, Pam Hoffman and Tom Taylor. We welcome you. Pam is our current champ. She's won $1,200, right? And she's being challenged by Tom Taylor in the middle of round one here. Tom did very well with his first round question, which means Pam has to work real hard to catch up with him. We'll see how this goes on right after we see about this. Now, shall we carry on? Here we go. Now, this is your first round question, Pam. Remember, you got to catch up. Now, George said, I think my wife is trying to kill me. Yesterday for dinner, she served me a pig with a blank in its mouth.
She served me a what with a blank?
I think my wife is trying to kill me. Yesterday, she served me a pig with a blank in its mouth.
A pig?
Well, you know the way they have roast pig and with something in its mouth, and they bring
just
it
to
four
them?
Guys,
Let
bring
me
it out
say.
On a big tray there. I think my wife is trying to kill me. Yesterday, she served me a pig with a blank in its mouth. Okay, Pam Hoffman. George said, I think my wife is trying to kill me. Yesterday, for dinner, she served me a pig with a blank in its mouth.
Razor blade.
Razor blade.
Yeah. Well, no, you know, on Halloween, they put razor blades in apples. You know,
yes,
that
right.
apple thing?
Okay, they do that.
Well,
yeah.
I mean, you take the apple out, you can what put
the
razor blade in.
What, in your opinion, would be the traditional thing for roast suckling pig with in its mouth?
An apple.
An apple, okay.
That's why I said razor
oh,
blade.
Oh, that's why she said razor blade. All right.
I think there's
something
around like an apple.
Yeah, that's right. Something round like an apple.
Like
what I had in mind.
I love breads. I had a gun in its mouth.
A gun in its mouth. Did you get the idea?
Well, I just thought about what people have called this show, and I said a bomb.
A bomb, yeah.
Hi.
A little hand grenade would look like an apple, wouldn't it, Charles?
Chuck chose bomb or grenade, Gene.
Bomb or grenade, very good there. Bomb or grenade seems to be the answer, Pam. What do you say, Barbara?
I said something nice and round like an apple, a grenade.
A grenade, yeah. You got the idea. Did you get the idea?
El Hando Grenado.
That's the perfect answer there. Did you get it?
Well, what, Gene? Like grenade.
Grenade, you got it.
Yeah.
That That's
hand.
Right.
That can't be a trend, though.
No. We won't let it be.
No.
Now we go to round two. and we'll ask Tom if he wants A or B.
B again, please.
B. There is one person who plays, and that's Marcia, because he didn't match that person who sat in your chair when we were together last time.
Well, I had nothing to do with this.
I know, nothing to do with it.
I shouldn't have all this pressure.
That's right. Harold said I just eloped with Fat Frida, and it was tough. She's so fat. Wait a minute. Wait till I give you the cue.
I mean, it was rough.
It was rough.
Not tough, yeah. Luckily, I'm reading the question.
Should we all read it aloud together, or should we have a trio?
Did you ever see an R? Yeah. It's like a R.
Well, I haven't got my glasses on, you see. Normally, when I read it, I hold them out there.
Gotcha.
You see. Yeah. Harold said I just eloped with Fat Frida, and it was rough. She is so fat. Okay. To get her out of the bedroom window, I needed blank.
Okay.
To get her out of the bedroom window, I needed blank.
It's been a while.
She's so fat.
Yes, I know.
Okay.
You need it a lot. I don't think you're
going to
know.
All right. All right, Tom, she's given us her answer, and you give us yours. Harold said I just eloped with Fat Frida, and it was rough. She's so fat, to get her out of the bedroom window, I needed blank.
Lard.
Lard.
See?
That's cute.
Anything slippery.
Of course.
Yes. Yeah. Now show us your rotten answer.
She was thinking of Lord.
Yeah, she was thinking of a heavy
burden. How do you really feel about it,
burden?
Though, Jim? You never could speak your mind. Hurling abuse the first day. I said a crane, but you see, I was thinking to get in into it.
That's okay. Like that.
I like it. Yeah.
All right. Now, Pam, you know what you have to do? You're going to have to match five when we get back to this commercial to achieve a tie. However, you could win it if you match all six. Right now, we've got this for you. All right. Now, Pam, five to tie, six to win. You got one rooter out there. Who is that, Pam? Who is that?
I think it's my cousin-in-law.
Your cousin?
The person I sold the Edsel to.
Oh, yes.
You know.
All right, here it is. 900-year-old Methuselah saith, this year marketh my bicentennial. It beeth 200 years since I last blanketh. Yeah.
As a director, could I hear it on the reverb?
On the reverb.
Reverb, please.
Yes. Well, I took the beat pause thinking it would be on the reverb, but it didn't. I couldn't hear it. Well, let me try it again. 900-year-old Methuselah saith, this year marketh. No.
Well, coming now.
That's sharp.
Is it working now?
Yeah.
Now it beeth 200 years since I last blanketh. Thank you. One out of three ain't bad. Yeah, that's right. It's really like the first day at school, you know, nothing works. And now it's working too much. Ready? Okay. Now, Pam, 900-year-old Methuselah saith, this year marketh my bicentennial. It beeth 200 years since I last blanketh.
Maketh love.
Maketh love! Yeah! By Jove, she got the idea, Avery.
By Jove, she did, didn't she?
Yes. Maketh love.
Well, in my vernacular, this is exactly the same.
Diddeth.
Diddeth. So that's one for her. Old Methuselah, he didn't think it was too bad.
He didn't mind. Time flew for him.
That's right.
Right. I thought about Charles and what he's told me about his life and everything, and I said maketh loveth.
Maketh loveth. Maketh loveth. All right,
Charles. I went a little further. I said, maketh loveth with abroadeth.
With abroadeth. How do you feel about maketh loveth?
Oh, just fine, thank you.
Good.
Your place or mine?
Well, I'm real close here.
You are?
I think maybe I cleaned it up a little too much.
Well, let's see it.
I said had a dateth.
Had a dateth. No.
Yeah, but
no,
you don't know about my dates.
It could have been just
dates.
A simple candlelight dinner for two,
no,
you
no.
know.
No, not my dates.
Oh, really?
You have to start somewhere. I think that's a good
right.
Spot.
Thank you.
Now, you got to match the two remaining ones, Pam, to stay in the game and achieve a tie. All right, Richard.
Maid loveth.
Maid loveth. That's 5-4 is the score. Hello, it's all up to you.
Again?
Again.
Well, you know, it's a shame, too, because I heard Dr. Joyce Brothers say on Celebrity Bowling just the other day that we could be sexually active through 1,000 years of age.
Oh, really?
Maid
oh,
love.
Yeah!
High
score. Good job. Good move. So, Pam, you pulled it out. The game ends in a tieth. And now we go to the tiebreakereth. And I push us this buttoneth. And revealeth one question for Thomas.
B.
You want B-eth?
Yeah.
Okay. The one who matches the most will be the winner. We have one tiebreaker for each of you. And here we go. Rodney the rich kid is so proper, he calls a popsicle a blank-sicle. You know Rodney the rich kid. Rodney the rich kid.
What did he say?
He is so proper, he calls a popsicle a blank-sicle. This is a good one, I think.
Yes, I like it.
Everybody ready down here? All right. Okay, Tom. Rodney the rich kid is so proper, he calls a popsicle a blanksicle. So proper.
Ice cream sickle.
You didn't thinketh enougheth. All right. Okay, Avery, Schreibereth.
Yes, that's right. He's so proper. He that. Calls a popsicle a father-sicle.
Father-sicle. Yeah.
Listen. Father-sicle.
Father-sicle. There are other variations of that?
The old father-sicle, but a better one because, what was his name?
Rodney the Rich.
Sugar Daddy.
Sugar Daddy. Popsicle. See, pop is a euphemism for father. What do you say, Barbara?
I'm trying to make up for the last one, but it didn't help.
Father-sicle. You got it there. Richard?
Really proper. It would be a pater-sicle.
Pater-sicle! Rodney the rich kid is so proper, he calls a popsicle a pater-sicle. Hello, pater.
Father.
Father-sicle. So, Tom. What happened to you? You had a momentary lapse there, and you opened the door to let Pam in. All she has to do is match one, and she will have won another game. Honolulu Lulu.
Uh-huh.
You were just there, then.
Hello.
Honolulu Lulu was arrested for blanking her grass skirt. I think that's a good one.
Why?
Honolulu Lulu was arrested for blanking her grass skirt.
Honolulu Lulu.
You got it.
I never used to get any of them.
Your suntan. Your skin is warm.
I see you come out of your shell for the last 3 minutes.
Okay.
Oh.
Everybody ready?
Thank you.
The Dodgers refused you. Okay, Pam, you ready? Here we go. Honolulu Lulu was arrested for blanking her grass skirt.
Trimming. No?
All is not lost, Tom.
Another momentary lapse.
They're coming more frequently, aren't they?
Okay.
Avery, what do you say?
I don't even trim my mustache. Smoking.
Smoking! Yes, you got it. Buster, what do you say?
You brought her, you smoker.
Okay. Chuck?
Oh, here we go. He's done this so many times before.
It's one of my best routines.
Smoking.
Yes, of course. Oh, child, you're too much. Really. Barbara, Honolulu was arrested for trimming her grass skirt, according to her. What according to you?
No, I was there. She was smoking it.
She was smoking her grass skirt. By Jove.
Tom, it's getting better every time for you. Smoking.
All right, Tom.
if she doesn't match, what's her name there?
What's her name? Whoever she
Marcia
was.
Wallace. It'll be another tie. Let's see what you got there, Marcia. We're all waiting for it.
Well, I don't know what it means, but I said smoking.
Yes, you did. So there we have another tie, and that means we got to go to another tiebreaker, but first we have to do a little business with America. Here we go to another tiebreaker, second one in a row. Remember again, the one who scored the most will be the winner, and if you don't score, you're going to go inside the box here. Forever. There. Okay, Tom, you may have A or B.
I'm going to have A.
You want A. That's this one here, right? Okay. Diane said to the psychiatrist, she said, Dr. Hastings, I really don't think you should blank while I'm telling you my problems. Doctor?
Doc, come here, sweetie.
Dr. Hastings. Dr. Hastings, I really don't think you should blank while I'm telling you my problems.
I know that part. What kind of a doctor was
he? He was a psychiatrist.
Oh, well, then actually your psychiatrist is what you call your operative word.
Right, psychiatrist. Okay, Tom. Diane said to the psychiatrist, Dr. Hastings, I really don't think you should blank while I'm telling you my problems.
Sleep.
Sleep is a good one. He said sleep. What do you say?
I really don't think a psychiatrist should laugh.
Laugh.
While you're telling him your problems.
That's a good one. Laugh and sleep are both good. Brett?
Hang in there, Tom. All is not lost. You're looking at a woman who hasn't had a cigarette for 10 months and she has laryngitis. I'm going to kill somebody. Nod off.
Nod off. There's one match for Tom. Yes.
Sleep.
Okay. Sleep or laugh, Barbara?
I'm very polite. A giggle.
A giggle. No giggling while I'm telling you my problems. And you, Richard?
Sleep.
You sleep. So Tom's got three at this moment. Marcia?
Jane, would you tell me how I dropped my pen on my shoulder?
How did that happen?
I have no idea. It just flew up in the air and
let me just
hit
see
me. It was not unpleasant, folks, actually.
No. It's right there,
oh, well,
isn't
no,
it?
I didn't.
You make a design.
Yeah.
We're not going.
Yes. Oh, okay. I forgot to tell you, it's indelible. It never comes off.
I'll treasure it for always. That was not altogether unpleasant either. I'm so easily entertained.
Would you show us your answer?
Laugh.
Now? Laugh it is. Okay. All right, Tom, you picked up three, and now, Pam, you need three to tie again or four to win. Let's see if we end this game.
Hot tunas.
Ronald McDonald said, last year I went to prison. And the food was terrible. Every meal, it was the same thing, a bucket of blank. Ronald McDonald said that.
Is that our Ronald McDonald of McDonald's?
I don't know. It's just a guy named Ronald McDonald. If you attach anything you want to it.
We got to speed it up, though.
Yeah, we got to speed it up there.
Someone hear that. That was the whole one.
That's the whole record. Now, Pam, Ronald McDonald said, last year I went to prison and the food was terrible. Every meal, it was the same thing, a bucket of blank.
That's a hard one.
Really?
Yeah. I'll have to say a bucket of French fries.
French fries. Well, I don't know. Avery, what do you say?
I say, wow. A bucket of Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Well, thank you. You heard of Ronald McDonald, haven't you? Okay, Brett.
Oh, I'm sorry, Pam. I said the Colonel's Kentucky Fried Chick.
That's it.
Chick.
Okay. Chuck?
Chuck said a bucket of slop.
Got to match them all now, Pam, down here in the bottom row. Barbara, show us yours.
I don't think I got this one. I didn't understand.
She's looking for French fries. You had hamburgers, so that means Tom wins the game. You had a hamburger and a hamburger there. All right. Right there to the little blue dot, sir. And we congratulate you for winning $1,200 in game number one. Thank you, Pam Hoffman.
I had a lot of fun.
Thank you.
I
want to spend these messages just for you. How do you feel? Join us next time, Magic 77, January 7th.